And finally, Cole Hornaday, what do you got for us?
Well, I picked up Nocenti's entry into the burger books from Dark Horse called The Seeds. It's written by Nocenti and drawn by David Aja. And this is if this is any indication what the burger books are going to be like, all told, this is a brilliant entry. This is a dark and grim and frankly terrifying look at the future that's just very close to us. It's a story. It's paced and it looks like a noir detective story. I would call it actually almost noir drama. It's black and white and green washed, which I think is a really interesting choice. There's two characters I read the first two issues. I don't recall how long it's going to run. Oh, four. It says right there. It's the story of Astra, who is a hard-boiled detective or hard-boiled reporter, and Lola, who I'm not quite sure who she is. Lola's plan is to escape over the wall to the Luddite community that lives without, obviously, technology. The world is polluted. Everything is dying. People wear gas masks. And Lola is she's so physically weakened by the pollutants in the environment that she rides in a wheelchair. But she's fallen in love with this mysterious figure on the other side of the wall, who we learn in the second issue bears a striking resemblance to a gray alien. And these gray aliens are actually harvesting organs from the people who live on the other side of the wall. So there's a lot of layers going on. That the illustration, Aja's illustrations are absolutely fascinating. Sometimes it goes from nine, sometimes it's eight, six grids, panels rather. And it is, it reminds me of reading the Margaret Atwood Matt Adams series, which just scared the ever-living crap out of me because it was so close to the bone as far as the destruction of our environment and political corruption and essentially the fall of culture and humanity. But it also reminds me a little bit of the Russian film, the Tartakovsky film, The Stalker, which is, you know, this bizarre world where at some point aliens visited us and left us their technology that we can't figure out. So people go to these places where time is all messed up and to try to gather the artifacts that these aliens left behind. It feels like that too. As I've complained about in the past, I usually don't like to read miniseries. I'd rather wait to get the collected edition. I'm actually really glad I picked up the first issue and going to keep reading it. It is a pretty dark story, but it puts you in some perspective that I think that I'm not going to speak for anybody else but myself, but I need this perspective right now. So
all right, The Seeds.
Thank you, Cole.
Thank you.